and turn the ball over.
Justin Davis, the senior, motions out of the backfield, and Brown flips it to him. Couple blockers on the edge, and he makes it across the 30-yard line. Stops tempo here, and in the pistol formation, they fake it to Davis, and Brown will take his first downfield shot. Darius Rogers goes up and makes a leaping grab inside the Alabama 35. Third and 12. Alabama rushing four. They still get near Brown, who completes it short to Taylor McNamara, the tight end, but he's well covered and far. Three on first down. Now motions out to an empty backfield. And Brown flips it far side. Nice one-handed grab. It's Taylor McNamara. Third and three. Davis to Brown's left. He flips it on a screen, and the catch is made there by Stephen Mitchell Jr., but he is...
Dahl, get Alabama to third down when they're on defense.
And first and 15, Brown flips it far side to Rogers. Cannot make a man miss. And he's... Bama rushing four, but Brown is still pressured. Steps up, shows some speed, and bolts straight down the field before sliding into Alabama territory.
Man to man, and watch Reuben Foster right in the middle turn his back. Right there, he's trying to stay with the receiver. He turns his back. Now Brown's going to go tempo here.
17-yard gain on third down. Now Brown's going to loop the ball down here. First attempt for Juju Smith-Schuster, and a flag comes in. This is the matchup we talked about.
15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
His head is, and does he locate the football as much as anybody?
Brown is flushed out and just throws it away. He's out. Third and 10. Brown in the flat. Catch made by Deontay Burnett, but he's run out. Welch is rising to their feet. Brown will be dropped. Anderson got him, and the Tide will take over. Brown from his end zone, and we'll just throw it away. There was nobody open. Number two, Adoree Jackson, the corner who played three ways last year but has not practiced on offense. He's just a decoy, and once again, the pressure. Second and 13. Brown just fires it into the ground. There was just nothing there. Sixth in the medal count. Three games. Play action. Brown wanted to go downfield, but will be. C goes to work, nursing a three-point lead, and Brown loops it far side. Just no chance there for Smith-Schuster. Davis motions out, but Brown miscommunication there. He looked it down there.
For SC.
Two-by-two look with Justin Davis in the backfield. Brown delivered short. Would have been
talked about that last year. Who's going to take the team over? Who's going to win the team over?
Brown puts it short to Ronald Jones. Not much there.
You know, Coker one time.
I do show pressure. It's deflected at the line and incomplete. Senior, though, but you're right. Depleted depth already at the linebacker position. And second and eight. Deflection. Intercepted. Humphrey scores. Another non-offensive touchdown for the Tide, continuing last year's trend.
We've got a receiver coming across. Right here is Reuben Foster. Watch how he picks him up. Good awareness. As he comes across, the ball's high. He's just there on good coverage, and because of the coverage, it made it tough for Burnett to be able to bring the ball in. And anytime that ball's tipped in the middle of the field, it's going to go up. And you got Alabama defensive backs that are ball hawks just waiting for it. And Humphrey, of course, makes the play. And once he caught the ball, he's walking to the end zone.
Humphrey, a friend, went to Smith-Schuster too often. Didn't spread the ball around. The opposite problem tonight, they can't get it to the key guy. This is flipped to Stephen Mitchell Jr. Breaks some tackles, still going on the far sideline. Down to the Bama 40. Spot the ball back to the 44. Brown from the pocket. Loops it down for Rogers, who can't quite make the catch.
Must be their film study when they go to that 3 and 4 wide receiver look, and they get Nick Saban and Jeremy Pruitt with 5-6 defensive backs. That's the matchup that they want. The experience of Rogers as a senior going up, matched up against a junior, Anthony.
Brown takes another shot downfield and loops it up and over the head of Deion. Bolden's just 2 of 9 on third down. Brown harassed, delivers it, and it's incomplete. Mitchell was. You fake it to Davis and flip it to Mitchell. And you cannot escape. Mitchell Fitzpatrick grabbed it. You want
help keep a play alive and run around and make plays? I think you'll see him at some point.
13 here, broken up. Jonathan Allen got a hand up. Some leadership role up front.
Watch his instincts. Look at his eyes. He's waiting. He's waiting as a defensive lineman. Times it up. Almost came up with the interception. That's a guy that's
quite a few in the Alabama defense. On third and 13, the pressure comes. Brown dumps it off. It's incomplete. Just no chance.
They are rushing four defensive linemen, and you have less than 2 seconds to get the ball out until you're going to get hit. That's not normal about who's going to replace Ryan Kelly.
Well, replacing Brown at quarterback is Sam Darnold. Big strong guy, and Sam's waited for this chance.
No, it's not. Clay Helton came over to him and let him know he was going in. Max Brown actually warmed him up right after that, and Clay came and told Max to stay ready, to keep his helmet on, that he might go back in. I'm not going to lie, though, Chris, looking at Sam right before he ran out, he looked nervous.
To him, he stumbled there a bit, but he's got some speed.
Brown, a pump fake, now just drop it. Finally, Juju Smith-Schuster.
But they don't quite have the depth. But boy, it hasn't shown up tonight. They're not fatigued at all.
In the pocket on second and 14, broken up.
But he used that game to really get him ready for a big year this year.
Third and 14, Brown harassed again. Flips it over the middle and over the head.
A whole different level.
How do you go to a different level than that? Brown, short completion there.
He's talking February, March, April, and May, year round.
Brown chased on third down into traffic. It's complete underneath. They tackled immediately.